Describe a plan in your life that is not related to work or study at the moment. I am quite busy with my studies, making money and taking care of my children. So I do not have a lot of time to take part in outdoor activities. Today, I would like to talk about a plan that I've had for a long time so far, which is taking part in an outdoor sport in the near future. This sport is mountain climbing. I think I can arrange time next year to have a trip to Baden Mount with my friends in this summer. I am really excited about the scenario of that day coming. The reason why I like this sport is that it can help me challenge myself to climb to the top of a mountain. It requires you to try non-stop and have to be patient to achieve the target. Besides, doing this activity can improve my physical health and reduce stress after hard-working days. Being on the top of a mountain gives me a feeling of conquering myself. I usually watch professional mountaineers on television or on YouTube. I'm really fascinated by this activity. Therefore, I also want to try this sport and conquer mountains like them. Describe your favorite singer or actor. Now I will describe a famous Vietnamese singer who I admire the most. His name is Ha An Thuan. He is around 36 years old now and his style of music is pop. He is well known for his warm and intense voice. He started his singing career in 2006 and, from that time on, he have launched many different hit songs and maintained his reputation during the past 16 years. Ha An Thuan is a rare celebrity who has never had any scandal throughout his career. He is really gentle and it is often expressed clearly through his style of communication and answering interviews. The reason why I am a big fan of him is because he is not just a talented singer but also because he takes part in social work frequently. He used to donate 3 billion dongs, around $150,000, in 2020 to help prevent the spread of COVID-19 in Vietnam. When I was in high school, there used to be numerous rules and regulations. And, one of them was the rule of bringing no mobile phone under any circumstances. At that time, cell phones were not extremely popular. However, despite the exorbitant prices, my parents still bought me one. I had to spend a lot of time outside the house. So my parents wanted to keep in touch with me. However, the principal of our school completely banned a cell phone on the campus as she believed that such a device was a distraction during the class. Adhering to this rule, I never dared to take the phone to my school. However, I did not feel uncomfortable and believed that such a restriction was necessary. Without smartphones, students could devote their breaks to communicating with each other instead of just staring at their phone screens. Besides, this rule helped us to focus more on our study and not be distracted by these devices in class. Well, I like to play different kinds of games, but when it comes to puzzle games, I believe that nothing is better than a puzzle that helps me to enhance my English vocabulary. My most favorite puzzle game is the word search game. I came to know about this game from my sister. When I played this game on her mobile, I immediately liked it. The graphics of the game was very elegant. Soon I downloaded this game on my mobile and started playing it. The word search boards are created with many fundamental topics, like food, animals, cities, countries, transport, home, colors, movies, etc. A word search game consists of the letters of words which are not placed in order. In this game, we have to find the exact order of each word with a picture which functions as a hint of the word. There are different levels from easy to hard. The harder level requires players to have wider lexical resources. Well, for one thing, this puzzle game is a great way to help players to enhance their imagination and reasoning. Moreover, it helps us learn new words. I learned a great number of new vocabulary by playing this game, which really helps me in my study. At the moment, my country already has regulations regarding the protection of the natural environment. However, there are still no rules about banning people who litter in public areas and on streets. In many large cities in Vietnam, people still have a habit of throwing rubbish carelessly on the roads or anywhere after they finish their drinks or food, as long as these places are not around their house. This makes the cityscape looks very dirty and untidy, especially in the rainy season when rainwater carries litter everywhere around the city. Therefore, it is imperative to implement a new law which punishes these environmentally unconscious individuals with heavy fines. In my opinion, it is quite easy to enforce such a regulation. The police could circulate the information about this new law in the media and penalize some people first. As a result, other Vietnamese will gradually get rid of their habit of littering indiscriminately, because nobody wants to lose money and be judged to lack awareness of protecting the surroundings. In the future, I would like to live in Da Lat City, which is the most famous tourist destination in South Vietnam. It is located in Lam Dong Province, around 300 kilometers from Ho Chi Minh City, where I am living now. The first time I traveled to this place was 5 years ago in Vietnamese Independence Day. Since that time, I have returned to this place once per year. There are many reasons why this place is popular with a great number of Vietnamese. Firstly, the landscapes there are incredible, with ranges of mountains surrounding the area. It is an area where inhabitants grow many famous types of flowers, e.g. lily or rose, which are sold all over Vietnam. It will be a great experience if you wake up early in the morning, climb the Lang Biang summit and enjoy the view of the whole city through fog blankets. Secondly, the atmosphere there is unpolluted and pleasant. Although it is chilly and not appropriate for many people, but it is my favorite weather condition. These are also the reasons why I would like to live in this region in the near future. Today I will describe an interesting piece of local news that all residents in our areas are interested in, which is the construction of a new leisure center. The news announces that Vingroup will construct a high-rise building named Vincom Center in my city. It will be a 15-story building located right in the center of the city. This center will cater mainly for shopping and recreational activities. People in my locality are excited because they could go there to watch films, play video games, buy clothes, shoes. Electronic devices or whatever consumer goods they want. Besides, family members could drink coffee or eat there because there are a lot of restaurants and coffee shops inside. At the moment, my area lacks a large entertainment area for children and their parents to spend their weekend in, or for young people to hang out in their spare time. Therefore, the appearance of a new leisure center excites all. Now I want to describe one of my talents which most of my family members and friends often compliment me on, which is my ability to cook. My mother was the one who taught me how to cook when I was around 10 years old. Because my parents are often very busy with their work, I've often taken care of cooking in my house. At the weekend, when my cousins or friends come over my house, I will be the cook. Most of the time, people enjoy my food and ask me to cook for them next time. However, I still try to improve my cooking skills as well as experimenting with new cuisines in my free time. I often watch videos on YouTube channels which share the way to cook different dishes or read cookbooks to learn new recipes and how to mix ingredients to create delicious courses. I feel very satisfied after I have devoted a lot of time and effort for food preparation and people enjoy my dishes. It is a kind of feeling that makes me want to learn how to cook more tasty courses and satisfy eaters. I want to describe a high-rise building that I like named Vincom Center in my city. It was a 15-story building located right in the center of the city. It is painted in elegant colors, mainly brown. And with the front side made of glass so that people can look inside the building when traveling outside. The center caters mainly for shopping and recreational activities. People could go there to buy clothes, shoes, electronic devices or whatever consumer goods they want. Besides, family members could drink coffee or eat there because there are a lot of restaurants and coffee shops inside. I like this place because it is near my house and I could watch films in the cinema here at the weekend. The movie theater is situated on the fifth floor. I also enjoy spending time in the bookstore in this center. Being able to immerse myself in books without charge always makes me want to travel there in my free time. I now want to describe a time when so many people were smiling. It was a month ago when I attended the wedding ceremony of my cousin. The wedding was held at the weekend in my hometown, which was around 100 kilometers far from my place of residence now. So, I had to wake up early in the morning and travel back there. My whole family and many relatives gathered together in her wedding. People seemed very happy and smiled during the whole ceremony because a lot of us had not met each other for a very long time and waited for so long to have such an opportunity to have a reunion. Before the ceremony officially took place, we moved from one table to another to talk to our relatives and close neighbors. Some people helped with the preparation for the wedding feast. although the organizer took care of most stuff. At round 11 a.m. we started to eat, and at the same time attendees continuously towards the stage, smiled and wished the couple a happy marriage. This is one of the occasions I saw all people were smiling all the time and felt happy. Now I want to describe a time I saw my friends argued with each other. It was 1 month ago when our group of friends hung out on Vietnamese Independence Day. The reunion took place in a comfortable and happy atmosphere at first because all of us had not gathered together for a long time, and that was a rare opportunity for us to meet up. However, during the meeting when we were talking about our plan for the future, my two close friends had a disagreement. The reason why they debated was because a friend claimed that we should not be an employee, but rather accumulate capital and start a business as soon as possible, even we have to get bank loans. Meanwhile, the other argued that we should not take a risk, and should remain in the same company, work hard and get promoted. They both debated for about half an hour, and finally we had to change to another topic so that the situation would not become too serious. In my view, whether or not one of these two views is reasonable has to depend on the circumstances of the individual. We cannot force other people to follow our viewpoint when they are in a totally different situation. Now I would like to talk about a time when my close friend asked me to help him choose a meaningful present for his sister 3 months ago. I think the reason why he asked me for help because he didn't have time and was not good at choosing and giving gifts. At first, I did not know what to choose. But after that, when I went across a bookstore, I immediately had a thought of buying a book. After that, I choose a book whose name is Heartwinning. The reason why I think it is suitable because it contains so many tricks to help readers to behave better and control their feelings in real situations. Besides, it always directs people to good values. Anyone who wants to have a better life and become a better person should read it at least once in their lifetime. I was sure that both my friend and his sister would be satisfied with this gift because it is a precious book and many people enjoy reading it. I felt very happy when I could help him to do this. And I will be willing whenever any of my friends need my help. I would like to tell you about a recreational activity near the sea that I want to try, which is scuba diving. It is a water sport that is becoming increasingly popular in famous islands in Vietnam such as Phu Quoc or Lý Sơn in central Vietnam. In order to be able to dive under the water surface for a long time, I will have to experience a few training sessions under the expert guidance of a professional. Besides, I also have to equip myself with diving clothing and underwater breathing apparatus. Although it sounds difficult, I know how to swim already and I think it will not be too challenging for me. The reason why I want to experiment with this kind of water sport is because I am really curious about what the seabed looks like when you see it firsthand. Moreover, watching coral reefs and marine animals swimming around has always been an idea that fascinates me, but I've never had a chance to try it before. So, next time if I have an opportunity to travel to an island, I will certainly experience this sport with my friends and family members. I have always enjoyed sharing things with others. Today, I would like to talk about one of those things which I shared with a roommate of mine when I was a college student. It was about 8 years ago or so when I was living with a roommate in the same room at a hostel. Even though we studied in different faculties, we both got along well and decided to share the room with one another. The reason why we shared the room with each other was because we could save a considerable amount of money each month. It is common when most students are often still dependent on their parents, and sharing their room with others could allow them to spend more money for food or other learning activities. I enjoyed sharing the room as it gave me a friend to talk to every day. Otherwise, I would feel very lonely. Although we had some problems in organizing our possessions in the room, but that issue got solved quickly as we both started to utilize the space more smartly. I have read many articles in my life. Today I will talk about an article about healthy lifestyle that I read last year. I read this article from the website fitness.com. I was browsing through a website when I saw the link to this article. The name of the article was very eye-catching. It was, "Look Younger, Live Longer." I clicked on the link and it opened this article. Nowadays, we all are living a sedentary lifestyle and facing many health-related problems. This article opened my eyes that to become healthier, it was all about making small lifestyle changes. I came to know that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. We should have a healthy and wholesome breakfast and never skip it. This habit helps boost our immunity and also helps us go through the day with full energy. I have never skipped breakfast since I've read this article, and I can concentrate on my work and studies better. It also said that walking for an hour a day is as good as 1 hour of gym. Since then, morning walk has become a part of my routine. I feel very fit and healthy and have rarely fallen sick since I made these small changes. I have bookmarked this article and read it often. I have also shared it with many of my friends and relatives. I will describe an old person I admire the most, who is my grandmother. She is around 70 years old now. In the past, because my parents were preoccupied with their work commitments, she was the one who took care of and spent most of the time with me. The reason why I admire her is because she is very knowledgeable and teaches me a lot of skills like cooking, time management, and other life skills. She also teaches me how to distinguish right and wrong and directs me to become a moral person. Besides, she can speak English very well too and is my first English teacher. It is thanks to talking to her that I can improve my English communication skills greatly. I can learn a lot of valuable lessons just by talking to her and listen to her life stories. I feel very attached to her and consider her as an important person who influences my character immensely. For all of these reasons, my grandmother is the one I admire the most. I am a person who likes to spend free time with my family. The activity we usually do is watching films together. I remember one Korean movie all my family members enjoy watching at home was, My Family is the Number One. We watched this series 4 years ago on TV after dinner in the living room. This comedy movie was about the life of a large family with three generations living in a house. All characters had a great sense of humor. They used simple sentences in daily conversations to cause audience to burst into laughter. The actress I liked the most was the small girl, Harry. Although she was just around 6 years old, her acting was very natural and lovely. I love this movie because it amused all my family members and helped us relax and reduce stress after class or work. Besides, I also learned many things from this movie, such as family love. It taught us to care more about others and valued the relationships with friends and relatives. I often read domestic and international news when I have free time. Now I want to describe a piece of international news which is interesting in the media recently. It was about Bitcoin. The news about Bitcoin always occurs whenever I am using my phone to surf the internet. People around me also talk about it almost every day. And I think that you also come across it often. The interesting thing about this coin is that its value varies almost every day. It can reach $50,000 over only 1 week, but also can fall to only $30,000 the following week. The value can be influenced by a tweet of a famous person on social media, for example, Elon Musk. To be honest, although the news was interesting, but I did not believe in cryptocurrency and that money can come as easily as they said. In my view, if we want to become rich, we have to work hard every day. Now I want to describe a quiet place that I often visit on the weekend. It is called Provincial Library. It is located right in the center of Bienwa City, where I am living now and near my place of residence. It takes me only 5 minutes to travel there from my home. The first time I traveled there was 5 years ago when my class in high school organized a trip to visit historic buildings in the city. Since then, I have been there at least once per month. In my free time at the weekend, I will go to this place to immerse myself in a world of books. There are many types of my favorite books there, from novels to scientific ones. The reason why I want to devote my spare time here is because reading in a library is much more interesting than reading at home. At the same time, it is quiet and not noisy like in a coffee shop. Although I like the atmosphere in these places, but I often cannot focus on what I am reading and are often distracted. I am a bookworm, so this library is my favorite place to read and relax. I want to describe a corporation named FPT. It is a company operating in technological sector and among the 100 largest Vietnamese companies. The company was established in 1988, experiencing a few decades of development, and it now has more than 30,000 employees. Their products are not used only in Vietnam, but also exported to other countries like Japan or America. FPT is a reliable partner of many large corporations in the world like Microsoft, Amazon Web Service, SAP. At the beginning, it was a food processing company. But then people knew this company as a communications and software company. At the moment, it covers a wide range of fields including software, communications, education and retail. However, the focus of this group is technology and most of their employees are engineers. Many Vietnamese households now use Wi-Fi or communication services provided by FPT. And I hope in the future Vietnam will have more large corporations like FPT. Because it is a pioneer in boosting the technological growth of Vietnam and contributes greatly to the process of modernizing our country. It is a great environment with well-paid jobs for any graduate from the major of information technology. My hobby is to photograph landscapes of the area that I travel to. So, I have learned how to edit and add effects to the original pictures, which makes them look better. I do not do this activity often because I only have time to travel at the end of each month. However, I usually take as many photos as I can. So, after each trip, I spend a great deal of time on my laptop to deal with them. Because I am not a professional designer. I do not have any design application on my laptop and have to use a website on the internet to edit them more quickly and simply. It is not very complicated to improve the quality of pictures. I often just adjust the brightness, change background colors and apply ready-made effects of the website to my photos. I feel very interesting when I edit the photos I take by myself. I could spend hours to deal with them and enjoy the final pictures. After that, I share them on Facebook and Instagram and feel so happy when my friends give compliments to my landscape photographs. My hobby after work is to photograph landscapes of the area that I travel to, edit and add effects to the original pictures, which make them look better. I do not do this activity often because I only have time to travel at the end of each month. However, I usually take as many photos as I can. So, after each trip, I spend a great deal of time on my laptop to deal with them. Because I am not a professional designer. I do not have any design application on my laptop and have to use a website on the internet to edit them more quickly and simply. It is not very complicated to improve the quality of pictures. I often just adjust the brightness, change background colors and apply ready-made effects of the website to my photos. I feel very interesting when I edit the photos I take by myself. I could spend hours to deal with them and enjoy the final pictures. After, I share them on Facebook and Instagram and feel so happy when my friends give compliments to my landscape photographs. I still remember the time when I was shopping in a street market in Da Nang, Vietnam. It was in December and Christmas was approaching. My friends and I decided to go out and shop in a street market near my university campus. The street market was located downtown and not far from the campus. It was such an crowded and unforgettable scene with the special Christmas atmosphere that I believe I would always remember it even after I came back. The kids were happy looking around with their parents, and the things on sale were various and not commonly seen at non-festival time. I bought a few postcards as I wanted to send best wishes to my loved ones through these postcards. I felt excited that I got the chance to buy those postcards with meaningful wishes. In terms of my feelings about the shopping experience, I would say it would remain as one of the most amazing experiences, shopping in a street market at a special time. Also, I would always remember the friends who were at my side and shared that excellent experience. From that time on, I believe I fell in love with the street markets. I am describing my laptop as it is the equipment I often use at home. It is a black colored laptop of Dell brand, and I bought it almost 5 years ago. This electronic device has helped me in many aspects, including work, study, and communication. The first important usage is saving data. I can save numerous ebooks, pictures, audio, and video clips in it, and the 300 gigabytes hardware capacity has allowed me to save plenty of them. Moreover, I can access the internet using this laptop. By connecting to the internet, I can access every website, check my email, and watch online movies or documentaries. This laptop has assisted me to raise my knowledge not only in my career and study, but also in learning the English language. I also communicate with others with this laptop, and this is the primary means of communication with my friends. I have already become dependent on my laptop. Definitely. The use of internet and computer has become unavoidable in this modern era, and this is indeed a very important tool for me. Now I would like to talk about a time when I was a team leader of the project that I took part in recently in my company. 2 months ago, my boss told me that because of my effort during the past few months, I was chosen to be the leader to lead the team complete an important project. I was very interested and happy because I worked very hard to have this chance, but I was also very nervous because of the responsibility. My team included 5 members in the accounting department. We worked together for about almost 10 years, so we knew each other very well and was confident that we could finish the work as expected. This project lasted in 2 months. We tried really hard during this whole period of time and usually stayed late in the evening at the company. However, because of my lack of experience as a team leader, we did not complete our project in time, and the effort of the team was wasted. Although we could not meet the deadline, my boss did not blame me for the tardiness and still believe and assign our team important tasks afterwards. I learned a valuable lesson and drew a lot of experience from this project and gradually had better management skills. I like to describe my favorite kind of climate, which is cool weather in the springtime. This kind of weather starts in January and lasts for 2 to 3 months. It is not hot like in the summer and not cold like in the winter, so we can go outdoors without wearing a coat, carrying waterproofs, and worrying about get sunburned or caught in a rain. In my country, during this season we celebrate Lunar New Year. It is the most important festival of Vietnamese. I often spend more time with my family members and hang out with my friends, as well as taking part in outdoor activities during this period of time. I sometimes go traveling to discover unfamiliar areas in Vietnam I've never been to before. This season is also considered a new start for everything when trees begin to sprout and people's new plans start to be put into practice. A new year also helps people to forget all the sadness and misfortunes of the previous year and hope that luck will be by their side in life. All these reasons explain why the weather of the spring is my favorite type. Now I would like to talk about a time when I encouraged my brother to give a gift to and confess his love to his girlfriend. 1 year ago, my brother told me that he liked a girl so much but did not want to express his inner feelings to her. It was a few days before her birthday and he asked me to give him some advice. I told him that he had to be braver and recommended that he should give her a present. Because of my encouragement, he agreed and asked me to help him choose a meaningful present for her. At first, I did not know what to choose, but after that when I went across a bookstore, I immediately had a thought of buying a book. After that, I chose a famous book named, Heartwinning. The reason why I think it is a suitable present because it contains so many tricks to help readers to behave better and control their feelings in real situations. Besides, it always directs people to good values. It was thanks to the gift I chose for him, they are now a couple. I felt very happy when I could help and encourage him to do this. Well, I would like to tell you about an object which is very important to my family. Like many other families in my country, my house also have a big photo. This photograph is on the wall of our living room because it is quite spacious. So, I think put there is suitable. This photo was taken 2 years ago by a professional photographer when my family went traveling to Dalat City, which is an unforgettable memory. We took a photo in the night market. This is the first picture that we took together and includes all family members. Whenever I look at the picture, it reminds me of the happy time I had with my family. I don't live near my parents now as they live in our hometown. Therefore, every time I miss them, I will have a look at the photo and it brings back memories we had together. This photograph means a lot to me because it makes me feel that my relations are always by my side and not feel lonely when living on my own. Now I will describe a time when I had to wait in a long queue, which made me feel very bored. It was 3 months ago when I went shopping in Big C supermarket near my house with my family. We went there because it was the end of the year and we wanted to buy new items for our house. However, because all other people also crowded this place for shopping, we had to wait a long time at the checkout counter. All buyers queued up in order and there was not any pushing or impoliteness between clients. I had to stand in the line for about 45 minutes. Which caused me to feel extremely bored. I did not know what to do except for surfing the internet using my phone and talking to my family members. However, I did not feel uncomfortable. It was because I often visited this shopping mall at the weekend, which sold products at a reasonable price. Besides, it also often offers discounts for frequent customers. Although it was crowded that day, it only happened on special occasions and this is still my favorite shopping center. My husband is a big fan of King of Sport, football. He often spends his free time watching sports events on television in the living room. So. Sometimes I also enjoy watching a football match with him. Now I will tell you about a special sporting event which took place 3 years ago. It was SEA Games, the biggest sports competition for Southeast Asian countries, held once every 2 years. The reason why I still remember it is that this was the first time U22 Vietnamese football team won the championship. The team had to overcome many strong football competitors like Thailand or Malaysia. In the final, we luckily defeated Indonesia 3-0, and became the new champion of Southeast Asia. After the match finished, our family celebrated the victory of our country by having a small party, while a lot of people crowded the streets to share the joy and happiness with others. Until now, it is still the moment I am very proud as a Vietnamese and will never forget. I would like to talk about one such exhibition that was organized in my city recently. This exhibition was held in the museum of the city where I visited with my friends. There was a small entry charge, fee for visitors, and we enjoyed seeing different forms of art that were on display inside. The very first section was about paintings where there were paintings of the famous painters. In the next section, we experienced drawings about the history of our city by local artists. In the final section, we could look at beautiful landscapes of the city where we lived. We stayed in the museum for about 3 hours and took a lot of pictures of us with the paintings inside. It gave us an opportunity to appreciate art as well as learning more about the history of our hometown. I felt very interested and relaxed when I could walk around and saw all these artworks in this museum. Now I will describe a skill that I am good at teaching other people, which is swimming. I spent most of the time with father when I was a child. We took part in a lot of activities together. Especially, we shared the same interest of swimming. My father and I often went to the swimming pool near my home at the weekend. And he was the one who taught me how to swim. At first, when I started to learn swimming, it was very difficult and I sank all the time. However, my father was very patient and skillful to show me how to use my arms and legs correctly. Thanks to my father's guidance, I finally could float on the water surface and swim forward. I used to guide some of my friends to be able to swim just in about 2 weeks. I first taught them how to move their arms and then their legs. After that, I show them how to combine these two parts of the body. Besides, I also tell them the way to breathe when swimming. I think that swimming is very good for health and is a great way to relax. So, being good at teaching this skill makes me feel proud of myself because I can help others and improve my ability to swim too. Telling others the truth is always difficult, but I remember there was a time that I had to tell my friend the truth. I have a friend, who is also my coworker. 2 years ago, after a long time of working together, I realized that she was very talkative and gossiped about other colleagues in the company. This affected harmony between staff of the company. Because I considered her my best friend, I advised her not to do that anymore by talking directly to her. At first, she was a little angry at me because of my advice. However, after that, I explained to her why I was so straightforward. I told her that nobody would like that character. Finally, she understood and was thankful for the truth. I believe that it is very important to be honest in life. This personality could help people recognize their shortcomings and better themselves day to day. I often read domestic and international news when I have free time. Now I want to describe a piece of international news which is common in the media recently. It was about Bitcoin. The news about Bitcoin always occurs whenever I am using my phone to surf the internet. People around me also talk about it almost every day. I am sure you read about it often. I actually do not really know the functions of this kind of money. I only know that people call it cryptocurrency, and its value keeps increasing daily. Many people are ready to invest a great deal of money with the hope that they will dig one coin. However, when I come across this piece of news, I am not very interested because I did not believe that money can come as easily as they said. If we want to become rich, we have to work hard every day. Now I want to describe my favorite toy when I was a child. It was a set of Lego which I felt very happy to receive on my 5th birthday. My father was the person who gave me it as well as teaching me how to play it. At the beginning, I did not understand the way to arrange all the building blocks to create a complete object like a car or a bridge. It was very difficult and I failed all the time. However, my father was very patient and skillful to show me how to link separate parts together in the game. He also taught me how to use my imagination during the process of creating a building or a vehicle. Thanks to using creative thinking, I could make almost anything I want to build. Playing this game also makes me become a quick problem solver now. The reason why I like to play this game is because my father was always my partner. We could enjoy our spare time together. Besides, the game also helps me to be more patient when facing a difficult situation. The most polite person that I really respect and happy to know is my boss. His name is Andy. I first met him when I went to the interview, and the first impression on my boss was that he was courteous and gentle. He was not like any of my previous bossy employers. In the interview day, he said, "Hi," to me with a smile on his face right after he saw me. Although he asked me a lot of questions when interviewing, his voice and attitude made me feel like he was already my friend. Thankfully, I was finally recruited and could work for his company. During the process of working for his company until now, I noticed he has always been willing to help his staff if possible. And I consider this company my second home because I do not often have cope with too much pressure at work when working with a polite and dedicated boss like him. Now I would like to talk about a time when my brother asked me to help him choose a meaningful present for his friend. I think the reason why he asked me for help because he didn't have time and was not good at choosing and giving gifts. So, I promised to help him. At first, I did not know what to choose. But after that, when I went across a bookstore, I immediately had a thought of buying a book. After that, I choose a book which name is, Don't Give Up, of a famous Vietnamese author, Le Tan Van. The reason why I think it is suitable for everyone because it contains so many tricks to help readers to behave better and control their feelings in real situations. Besides, it always directs people to good values. Anyone who wants to have a better life and become a better person should read it at least once in their lifetime. I was sure that both my brother and his friend would be satisfied with this gift because it is a precious book and many people enjoy reading it. I felt very happy when I could help him to do this. And I will be willing whenever any of my family members need my help. I would like to talk about my favorite place that I traveled to 4 years ago. This is Da Nang City and also a top tourist attraction in my country. It is located in the south central of Vietnam. This is a special occasion for me because I received a bonus from my boss, so I decided to organize the trip with my family member in this city. We stayed in a hotel near the beach. And it was a right decision because from our room in the fifth floor of the hotel, we can have a look of the whole beach. Besides, the food was yummy, such as kwang noodle, XEO cake, and others. Moreover, the staff were very kind, friendly, and willing to help me in need. I really enjoyed this trip, and in the future, if I come back here again, I will stay in this hotel because it was worth my money and really helped me to reduce stress and chill out after hard working days. Now I want to describe my favorite toy when I was a child. It was a set of Lego which I felt very happy to receive on my fifth birthday. My father was the person who gave me it as well as teaching me how to play it. At the beginning, I did not understand the way to arrange all the building blocks to create a complete object like a car or a bridge. It was very difficult and I failed all the time. However, my father was very patient and skillful to show me how to link separate parts together in the game. He also taught me how to use my imagination during the process of creating a building or a vehicle. Thanks to using creative thinking, I could make almost anything I want to build. Playing this game also makes me become a quick problem solver now. The reason why I like to play this game is because my father was always my partner. We could enjoy our spare time together. Besides, the game also helps me to be more patient when facing a difficult situation. Now I want to describe a trip I frequently make but do not like. It is the trip back to my home in the evening. On every weekday, like all other people, I have to travel 3 kilometers to work in the morning, and after 8 hours of hard work, I come back to my home at 5 in the afternoon. But on the way back home, I often get stuck in a traffic jam halfway at a crossroad. Because there are a lot of other people going back home like me, and students return home after school. The crossroad often takes me 20 minutes to get out of it. I dislike it so much because it takes me too much time. Besides, too many people in a narrowed space make me uncomfortable. I hope that in the future people will be more polite, and do not push each other during the congestion. Now I want to describe my first day in primary school. It was a long time ago, around 25 years, but I still remember clearly what happened that day. My mother took me to the school, which was in the center of Bienhoa City, where I grew up. When entering the gate, I felt everything totally new from friends to teachers. My mother quickly led me to the classroom and exchanged something with my teacher. After that, my mom came back home and we started the class with Vietnamese language. The teacher taught us the alphabet again, which we already learned in nursery school. After 2 hours of serious learning, we have a 20-minute break. During this time, I made a lot of new friends and we talked and had fun together throughout the whole break time. On the way back home, I felt happy and shared with my mother all what I experienced at school with my classmates and teachers. I will never forget the first day I entered primary school because it gave me a lot of new experiences I had never had before. Now I will describe a famous Vietnamese singer who I admire the most. His name is Hà Anh Tuấn. He is around 36 years old now and his style of music is pop. He is well known for his warm and intense voice. He started his singing career in 2006 and, from this time on, he have launched many different huge hit songs and maintained his reputation during the past 16 years. Hà Anh Tuấn is a rare celebrity who has never had any scandal throughout his career. He is really gentle and it is often expressed clearly through his communication style and answering interviews. The reason why I am a big fan of him is because he is not just an admirable singer but also because he takes part in social work frequently. He used to donate 3 billion dongs, around $150,000, in 2020 to help prevent the spread of COVID-19 in Vietnam. I would like to talk about a time when I was surprised to meet a friend again after we left college on our class reunion in a restaurant a year ago. We were close friends and very compatible in high school. He now is not only a finance director in a large corporation but also the greatest leader. His name is Andy. He has a simple and short haircut, which is quite common for man of his age. However, he wore a pink suit, making all other friends stare at him with a surprised look. The reason why we were so surprised is that his clothes are girlish from his shirt to his shoes. I thought this style of dressing is more suitable for women than men. Even females do not often wear a fully pink set of clothing like him. However, When I chatted with him, I felt very interesting because he had a way of making people feel happy and comfortable when they're around him. I enjoyed the dinner and had fun when I could meet him again. Now I will describe my current job as an accountant. I have been doing this job for 10 years until now since I graduated from university. I developed the passion for this job when I was a trainee in an accounting company. It involves a variety of activities, such as keeping financial records, preparing balance sheets and financial statements. The reason why I think it is perfect for me is because this job requires me to be careful when working with statistics. It helps me to train my patience as well as becoming a good problem solver. Besides, it enhances my computer skills, which I could apply in many other activities in life. Finally, the salary for this job is enough for me to cover my cost of living and my children's tuition fees. So, in my opinion, this is the most appropriate profession for me. When I was a student in university, I had a close friend named Lan. On a Tet holiday, which was a traditional festival of Vietnamese taking place at the beginning of January annually, I was invited to visit her house and stayed there for 2 days and one night. My friend's family lives in a peaceful and beautiful countryside about 100 kilometers far from my city with three generations living together. During my stay, I had a lot of unforgettable memories which I never experienced before. One of them was the activity of wrapping the sticky rice square cake, a type of Vietnamese traditional food. When I arrived at her house, I saw a very interesting activity. All her family members, including grandparents, parents, and her siblings, were making a type of cake. I asked to help them take part in some simple steps like washing ingredients such as rice, pork, beans. After finishing the wrapping step, we started to boil these cakes in a very large pot. The process took around 12 hours. I really enjoyed the time I spent being with this family and doing this traditional activity. All her family members were friendly and welcoming. I felt that this place was like my house. Besides, this is the traditional I like the most because it helps strengthen family bonds. However, I would not like to live there because the weather in my friend's area is too hot in the summer and too cold in the winter. In the summer, the temperature could reach a peak of 40 degrees Celsius and it could decrease to 0 degrees Celsius in the winter. Because I am too familiar to living in the temperate climate of my area, I do not think I could adjust to the weather there. So, although I enjoy spending time with her family members, I would not like to live there for a long time. Actually, a year ago I made a plan with my family members to visit a zoo in Biên Hòa City. It was really fun there as the atmosphere was pleasant and the park is extremely huge. We saw a lot of wild animals there such as snakes, lions, tigers, monkeys. but we were not allowed to go close to their cage. The fifth place we visited was the area for tigers. They are carnivore animals and mostly eat meat or the flesh of animals. Next, we stopped at the areas for monkeys and threw some food inside the cage. These monkeys quickly picked the food up and ate it. Beforehand, I only saw tigers only on video or photo. So when I saw them in real, I afraid and look at them from far away. All of my family members felt very interested and relaxed when visiting this zoo. If I have a change in the future, I would love to see them again. I would like to talk about my favorite place 2 years ago that is unforgettable to me. This is Da Nang City and also a top tourist attraction in my country. It is located in the south central of Vietnam. At that time, my father has a Toyota Innova, which was a seven-seater car. So my father decided to organize the trip with all family members in this city. During this trip, we took some rest and had breakfast at a roadside eatery. You know, the weather was so nice and pleasant. The food was delicious and perfect, such as kwang noodle, XCO cake, and others. Besides that, we drove by car to go sightseeing. Many of the landscapes were very amazing and famous for Ba Na Hill, Nan Nuc Beach, Han River. I also took many photos with my friends and posted them on Facebook. Moreover, local people are very kind, friendly, and willing to help me in need. I really enjoyed that car trip and will never forget it because of several reasons, and I want to come back this city again. Now I will tell you about a trip I got lost on the way. 5 years ago, I traveled a long journey, which I had by car from Biên Hòa City to Matagui Forest City. I had four traveling companions who were my close friends in the car with me. During this trip, because this was the first time we went by car to this place, we realized that we were lost and needed some help. We didn't know the streets to come to the hotel I booked and started feeling nervous and scared. Luckily, thanks to the Google Map, it helped us to arrive at the hotel quickly and safely. I have many apps on my phone, but the app I find to be helpful is this Google Map. I started to use this app about 5 years ago and my friend introduced it to me. I had to download this app from the App Store and use it free. After this trip, I think that everyone should have this app on the phones. I believe this app is really useful and a must-have for everyone because it's convenience. Well, I usually enjoy dinner at home with simple and traditional dishes, but it was an occasion that I had a very special meal in a fancy European restaurant. This is a special occasion for me because I received a bonus from my boss, so I decided to organize the party with my best friends and we had it nearly 2 years ago. The name at the restaurant is Blue Sky, and it's a great place for family and friends to eat together. The restaurant offers an excellent view as well as a nice decoration. I had to admit that it was the first time I ate Western food. Although the taste is quite different from what I often eat in traditional Vietnamese restaurants. In general, the dishes were delicious and perfect, such as seafood, tomato soup and chicken with some fresh salads on the side. I realized that European cooks focus a lot on the appearance of their dishes, which was the reason why the price was a little higher than in other eating places. I truly liked this dinner because it really helped me to reduce stress and chill out after a hard-working day. Now I want to describe one thing that I bought and was very satisfied with. It is a gift for my brother. 2 years ago, my brother asked me to help him choose a meaningful present for his friend. I think the reason why he asked me for help because he didn't have time and was not good at choosing and giving gifts. At first, I did not know what to choose. But after that, when I went across a bookstore, I immediately had a thought of buying a book. After that, I choose a book which name is heartwarming. The reason why I think it is suitable for everyone because it contains so many tricks to help readers to behave better and control their feelings in real situations. Besides, it always directs people to good values. Anyone who wants to have a better life and become a better person should read it at least once in their lifetime. I was sure that both my brother and his friend would be satisfied with this gift because it is a precious book and many people enjoy reading it. I felt very happy when I could help him to do this. And I will be willing whenever any of my family members need my help. At the moment, I am working as an accountant. Now I want to describe a problem when I used my computer to import data in the workplace. 2 weeks ago, when I almost finished the financial record statement to report to my boss, my computer suddenly turned off for no reason. I did not save the record yet, and it means I had to start over again. At first, I was very disappointed and panicked. I tried to restart my computer so many times with the hope that I could restore the data. However, it was useless. After that, I had to call IT Center to support, but they could not do anything also. I felt quite sad because it was the effort of my whole day. But I finally had to accept to do all the report again. And had a very valuable lesson, which is to save the data often during my working process to avoid that situation happening again. I would like to talk about a time when I was surprised to meet a friend again after we left college on our class reunion in a restaurant a year ago. We were close friends and very compatible in high school. I was surprised that my best friend now is not only a finance director in a large corporation but also the greatest leader. His name is Andy. He has a simple and short haircut, which is quite common for a man of his age. Through a conversation with him, I realized that he had all the qualities needed to be a good leader, such as he's hardworking, patient, understanding, and talks very politely with everyone. Especially, he knew exactly how to connect with people in his network and motivate them to achieve common targets. The reason why I was so surprised is that in the past he was just a normal student. But at the time he was successful in his career. You know, when I chatted with him I felt very interesting because he had a way of making people feel happy and comfortable when they're around him. Secondly, I learned a lot of things from him. This allowed me to enhance my knowledge about work experience. Finally, Andy was the best person that very good in the job because he was very confident and solved problems quickly and effectively. So I was truly lucky to have a friend like him.